My name is Erica. I'm a Lithuanian woman and also a mother. I'm 28 and all my life I live in Vilnius. Lithuania can be called a pioneer in a field of gender equality legislation.
Mostly first women which started women's movement were here in Vilnius University.
You just started to work on the law of gender equality in Lithuania?
We looked to the Nordic countries, to their experience, and looked as the ideal for society, for us, let's say. And of course we knew that in these countries there are acts on gender equality or similar laws. And we thought this is very good practice. So in the very beginning we started to talk about that. And later on we had the project with European Council. We have programs which allowed us to create a group to draft the first draft of law. It was in 1995. And in 1999, the Equal Opportunities Ombudsman was appointed and the office was established. So.
I have a son. His name is Emil. I raise him alone with the help of my family and friends. According to Lithuanian concept of family, the two of us are not considered as a family because I'm not married. When we speak about gender equality, we are always faced with three main fields of problems: women in labor market, violence issues, and human trafficking. 25% of women in Europe have been victims of physical violence at least once. Lithuanian numbers are different. Those are 63.3. I remember the case about family concept. It was also something about marriage.
In Lithuania, we have very strong rhetorics of traditional family values. Government recognizes like family only married couples with children. So if you are a single mother who was never married, according to this concept, you actually are not family with your child. So it's very discriminative concept. Books, notebooks from which people are learning, we can find very like funny examples when women who is not married compared with zero. It means that if you are not married, you are like zero. But if you are married, it's the same like the husband is one, and if you are zero next to one, you becoming 10. Yeah. So, and it's in school programs, so you can.
In the school programs.
Yes.
It's quite easy to adopt laws, but it's very difficult to change people's mind. To change patriarchal attitudes, which are very, very deep and very strong in Lithuania. You see innocent things, they show these attitudes. For example, now we have an advertisement of a talk show or something on TV about just violence of men against women. And in advertisement, they don't ask why men beat women. No, they are asking for what? Už ką? For what? For what she is guilty that he is beating. So here you understand that he has right.
Jūs esat pensione, kuris paslaugas smurtą patyrusio moterim, prekybos žmonėmis aukoms. Pas mus per metus vidutiniškai paslaugų yra suteikama 1000-1200 asmenų. Pakankamai didelis skaičius. kad smurtas šeimoje nėra nusikaltimas Lietuvos Respublikoje ir vis galioja dar ta privataus kaltinimo tvarka, tai mes susikūrėm tokią, nu, pakankamai gerą lankščią metodiką dirbti su šeimomis, kurios turi smurtą šeimoje problemą. Yra žmonės, vyrai, kurie ateina ir kalba apie tai, kad nu, nesupranta, kas darosi šeimoje. Nes jie 10 metų gražiai gyveno, niekas jam nepasakė, kad smurtas, kurį jisai naudoja prieš moterį, nu, yra blogai ir pati moteris niekuomet neišreiškia kažkokio nepasitenkinimo. Pradėjom galvoti apie tai, kad smurtautojas taip pat yra Lietuvos Respublikos pilietis, kad jam taip pat reikia paslaugų ir pradėjom siekti tapti jo draugais. Geriau mes ten būsim draugais, patarėjais, kaip tvarkyti su esamą, sakysim, kritinę šeimos situaciją, negu jisai susiras kažkokį. Mes pradėjom kalbėti apie tai, kad vyrai, pagalvokit, kad yra nu, nesąmonė, argi jūs tikit, kad ta moteris, kurią jūs mušat, skriaudžiat, pastovi žeminat, gali jūs mylėti?
Let's say I'm experiencing some discrimination in gender issues. What, as a woman, I can do in Lithuania? I mean, what can I do? Okay, I'm feeling bad, my salary is lower and they're abusing me, my boss is like total bastard, or I don't know, what could I do, or like...
Su moterų teisų pažeidimais apie grožio konkursus ir modelių sritį. Ap šios sritį labai mažai kalbama yra apie prekybę žmonėmis, bet jinai yra problema labai aktuali.
Ir dažnai pasitaiko, kad na, jaunos mergaitės turbūt vis tiek pagrindė labai veržiasi į šitą sritį, nori tapti modeliais, profesionaliais.
Taip, ir jas labai lengva apgauti, va čia yra baisioji pusė. Kadangi aš jaunų mergaičių matau labai daug ir matau, kokia ta problema didelė, dėl to ir kilo ta idėja, kad reikia kažką daryti. Jos iš tikrųjų yra naivios dar, jom įtikinti, kad tu išvažiuosi, tavęs laukia dideli pinigai, tai mergaitės, aišku, pagal save vertina, kad ten negali būti kažko baisausios, tiesiog.
Mhm. Ir tai, ten žodžiu, kaip ten toliau viskas vyksta, ta prasme, bet patikėjęs tokiu konkursu, bandai važiuoti ir pasirodyti.
Ir būna taip, kad sukūrėmi konkursai po priedangą, kad suorganizuoti šau, pakviesti turtingų vyrų, iš mergaičių timami pasai, sakykim, tai ir pilnametės gali patekti.
Man atrodo, kad tai priklauso nuo moters pačios, ar jie gerbia ar negerbia. Jeigu moteris pati save gerbia, tai man atrodo, kad ir aplinkiniai jie gerbs.
Laws, legislation, NGOs and other organizations can exist, but without love and appreciation for oneself as a woman is not going to do any good. First, you have to look inside yourself, find inner freedom, cross the boundaries and get out of the box.